Yo, let me guess. You're here because you're wondering, is my phone spying on me? Is it there to help me, or is it there to assist me? Like it was sold to me. Every tap, every swipe. It's like feeding a surveillance machine. But does it have to be that way? This is the About Phone. I want to show you why with this phone, you'll be able to get all of your privacy back and maybe some of your sanity.
Look at me. I'm like a TikToker, videotaping in the van. I'm a working dude. I don't need frills. I don't care about the latest Snap Lizard or Bionicle chip that Apple came out with. It's not that big a deal to me. So I want to cater this video to regular dudes, working dudes, the blue collars of the world. Like this guy right here. Hey, bud.
What you doing? That level's kind of short, don't you think? No? It's all good? Okay.
You're the boss. But don't get it twisted. This video is for everyone.
Every smartphone, every phone at all, is constantly connected to the nearest cellular tower. Every phone, even when the screen is off, you think it's doing nothing, you can't see it because radio frequency emissions are invisible. It's screaming in the air, saying, here I am, here I am.
The more time you are spending scrolling through social media, the more money they make. It's simple. Your screen time equals their money.
Your phone is always f***ing with you. It's notifying and, you know, and I just didn't want to be a part of that anymore. I wanted to, you know, be a little more connected to life outside.
You can still call people.
All the apps are all, they're all tracking you. They're all doing all kinds of shit. But initially, really, just to not be, you know, a slave to this thing.
Yeah.
Disgusting. Let's talk about what's broken. The average smartphone today, it's like having a personal assistant in your pocket, but that personal assistant eavesdrops on every one of your conversations and sells the juiciest bits to the highest bidder. The apps, the ads, the algorithms, they're all part of a system that cares more about your data than you, the individual, the user. And keep in mind, it's not just about ads, it's about autonomy. Big tech has built an ecosystem where we are the product. And I'm going to let Hakeem Anwar, the CEO of Above Phone, say it in his own words.
Didn't want any part of that. I was like, not going to help build this prison up around me, and so I left.
That's where the Above Phone comes in. This phone is designed to work for you, not some faceless corporation. I mean, think about it. How much of your phone use seems like it's helping you, and how much of it feels like it's feeding some system that you can't control? Switching to the Above Phone isn't like switching to some completely alien device or even a dumb phone. It's actually very seamless. Just pop in your SIM card and you're good to go. All your favorite apps, they're not all there. And that's by design. All your favorite apps are spying on you.
That they come with. We don't put these apps on by default because our rule is we only go with open source apps, but the phone gives you the tools to do that.
Now, if you're worried about the setup, here's something. You could install GrapheneOS on your own. You could take your own degoogled Android phone or degoogle it yourself, and there's plenty of guides online. I'll link one right here. But the problem is there's no handholding. You're kind of in the wild there, and you could potentially brick your own phone. And that's why Above Phone has a one-on-one service. You can book your free call, get all the help you need. They set it up, first of all, it's set up out of the box. As soon as you pull it out of the box, it's ready to go. It's already set up. All you got to do is sign in with, I mean, you don't even sign in. It's just ready to go. You just set up a PIN and that's it. You're in. There's no friction. It's just ready. I mean, that's how it was whenever I unboxed the device. But basically, all you have to do is give them a call if you ever run into any issues, which I think is just a godsend. And here's another thing. you need different profiles, one for kids, one for work, one for personal, one for extremely private stuff, you can set that up. It's in the settings, you got profiles. What happens in those profiles stays in those profiles. This is part of a bigger idea, the idea that you can finally start taking control in a world that's constantly trying to take it away from you.
Before I get into my final thoughts, I want to give you a quick view of the interaction I had with the customer service department, so check it out.
Hello, can you hear me?
I can. Oh, wow, yes, yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
Okay, phenomenal. How are you?
Doing great, thanks. How are you doing?
I'm doing okay. I'm doing really great, actually. This thing is phenomenal, so I just really wanted to call and see how I have one issue, just the one. It's the canine mail. That's the one thing that I couldn't get hooked up just right. So if you could help me out with that, that'd be phenomenal.
Yeah. What kind of email do you want to set up there?
My main email for business is Gmail, and I have an OAuth issue with that.
Basically, now there is Thunderbird for Android, and I'm not sure how this works, but for some reason, Google or Gmail accounts, they only work with Thunderbird for Android and stop working with K9 Mail. So the solution for you would just be to download that. It's on F-Droid. You can just search for it there. Open F-Droid and search for Thunderbird.
Okay, let's do that. I'll do that right now just so we can get it done.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm going to go through that and figure that stuff out in just a moment here. That one was my main question for you. And then also, I believe the phone came with Heliboard installed.
Mm-hmm.
Or Heliboard, however you pronounce it. One thing, when I did have the iPhone that I was using, and I know that this has to do with mappings that are created either on device or on the server to map to a certain person's typing style. Heliboard doesn't have that natively, I don't believe. And neither does the other third-party keyboard that I downloaded. It was Futo from Lewis Rossman, the Futo keyboard. Because you got the Futo microphone, that one's great, and it works wonders. But the typing experience isn't the best. Do you know about anything on how to make that typing experience better with the Futo keyboard or no?
Yeah, I would also need to investigate. For a Heliboard, I know that there are a lot of settings, but I guess you already went through these and didn't find what you were looking for.
Yeah, didn't find what I was looking for. It's not the hardest thing in the world. I use the microphone more for anything just because I'm usually texting and driving, which I shouldn't be, but I'm using that more often, so it's not the biggest deal to have that issue. And I get it, that's not really part of the OS, that's more of just an app that works with it, and I can get a third party and that wouldn't be an issue.
Something that you can do too, if you know about another keyboard that would do the things that you need, even if it's proprietary, on this phone you can just deny it network permission, and that way you block it from being able to connect to the internet, so you can make any keyboard private. The issue with a keyboard app is usually, like, when it connects to the internet, why would it do so? And, like, what are the implications of that? It could potentially collect all of your keystrokes and lock that. But on this phone, you have access to the network permission on every single app. So just block that. That way you can, even if you wanted, use the Google keyboard or Swift key, which is another famous one, and make it private. Like, not be subject to the problems. The phone gives you the tools to do all that too.
That's phenomenal. You see, I was really wary of using that because I didn't know what the methodology would be for managing those keystrokes and recording them. And it's just network access. Man, and it pops up with every new app that you install. It says, do you want to give it network access? And I didn't.
Exactly.
Ah, that's my bad. I could just do that. You know what? It's a good thing I had this call with you. Now I can use the app that I'd like to use. I love that I have it, and I'm happy that I'm using it.
but it's more of trying to be minimalist without going to a dumb phone yet.
That's the idea of it. It's really built or designed in a way that you are in charge and the phone doesn't suck you in like other phones tend to do. Like, yeah, they keep you trapped, right? And on this phone, it respects you as an individual making your own informed decisions.
The Above company, as you can tell, has gone above and beyond in this regard. I had to reschedule about twice, and that was on me. That was my bad. So they helped out in an incredible way. Now, there's more coming in the future. I'm not just sticking to an introductory video. I'm going to talk about how to use this phone with GrapheneOS and everything else that goes along with it, like how to get the apps that you want and which ones to use and how to set up network permissions and how to get into the total security aspect of this phone. There's also a cell service that Above Company's coming out with. There's also a laptop they're coming out with. There's all sorts of things coming in the future. But for now, I think this does justice to exactly what they're built to do. Now, if you're feeling froggy and you want to buy yourself an Above phone, click the link in the description. You get a significant discount and it's an affiliate link, so I get supported. So let me know how you think the video goes in the comments and show me some love with subscribing and liking. Peace out.